We've been telling each other stories since the beginning, since we wrote on cave walls and gathered around campfires. But somewhere along the way, we forgot.
Even the smallest details had the designer's attention. For instance, the brake pedal is reshaped to fit your foot more comfortably. And on what other car would you find a combination of all these things with such luxury features as this year's front ventipane control crank, ordinarily found in only the highest priced cars?
Now, I know that's pretty hard to watch, especially if you're still talking about features, but here's the problem. Along comes the internet. And if you're still stuck in the 50s talking about features, you're screwed. And the reason is because your homepage isn't your homepage anymore. This is your homepage. Page one of a Google search, right next to everybody who, if you're still talking about features, is going to sound pretty much like you sound. So what's the answer? Well, I believe it's storytelling. But now, just, you know, please, what I'm not saying is that means that your homepage should start with, well, once upon a time. What I'm saying is that you should start to take advantage of the principles of good storytelling. Ed will say to me, if I can get somebody on the telephone, 9 times out of 10 they become a customer. Jan will say, if we can get somebody in a demo or in a GoToMeeting, 9 times out of 10 they become a customer. Now, Ed and Jan aren't the world's best benefit and feature listers. But what happens, as you well know, is it's the Ed vibe, it's the Jan vibe, it's the comfort that they're able to create, it's the engagement. And that's what storytelling does. And can you imagine taking that same power and moving it earlier in the sales cycle? Do you think maybe leads would increase? Do you think maybe sales would go up? Well, in my experience, it's inevitable. And that is what I do.